Well, what's scarier than things that go bump in the night on Halloween? Rain, snow, and cold temperatures during trick-or-treating. Our next weather meteorologist, Karen Carter, tells us all about the scary weather of past Halloweens and if we're in for a trick or treat this year.
Halloween is steeped in tradition dating back hundreds of years, but trick-or-treating in the U.S., like we know it today, began in the 1930s. Looking to the past 150 years of recorded weather data can give us an idea of what we can expect this Halloween and in Halloweens to come. Out of the last 150 years, Halloween in Metro Detroit has been overall rather mild. 53 Halloween days have reached temperatures in the 50s, while 45 Halloweens have had temperatures in the 60s. 35 reached highs only in the 40s, and thankfully we've only had 6 Halloweens with highs in the 30s. But 11 Halloweens have been warm with temperatures in the 70s.
In fact, our warmest Halloween on record was in 1933 with a high of 79 degrees. Well, the coldest was in 1917 with a high of only 34 degrees. Whew. And in more recent years, we reached the record for the wettest Halloween in 2013 with over 1.5 inches of rain.
And our snowiest Halloween was just last year with 0.2 inches reported. We've only had 9 Halloweens with a trace or more of snow. So more Halloweens have been rainy rather than snowy, with a total of 83 Halloweens recording any precipitation at all.
And 67 dry Halloweens with no rain or snow.
Halloween is just days away, treating us to mild temperatures so we'll be able to leave our winter coats at home this year. However, a frightful trick of rainy conditions could dampen our evening fun if the cold front doesn't push through quickly enough during the day. This means we may need to add an umbrella to our costume.
Trick or treat!
Now that's the science of weather. For CBS News Detroit, I'm meteorologist Karen Carter.